Hello, welcome back to this channel, Gain Java Knowledge, and today we are going to discuss inter-thread communication, how one thread can communicate with other threads. So here we will use wait notify notify all method to perform inter-thread communication, and these three methods are present in java.lang package. Two threads can communicate with each other by using wait method, notify and notify all methods. The thread which is required updation, it has to call wait method on the required object. Then immediately the thread will enter into waiting state. The thread which is performing updation of object, it is responsible to give notification by calling notify method. And after getting notification, the waiting thread will get those updations. Wait, notify and notify all methods are available in object class but not in thread class, because thread can call these methods on any common object. To call wait method and notify all methods, compulsory the current thread should be the owner of that object. That is, the current thread should has lock of that object. The current thread should be in synchronized area, means if we are using synchronized method or synchronized block, then only we can use wait notify and notify all method. Hence we can call wait notify and notify all methods only from the synchronized area, otherwise we will get runtime exception saying illegal monitor state exception. And once a thread calls wait method on the given object, first it releases the lock of that object immediately and entered into the waiting state. Once a thread calls notify or notify all methods, it releases the lock of that object but may not immediately. Let us see in the code how wait notify and notify all method works. Here it is an example of inter-thread communication. Here I have created one class inter-thread communication, and here I have created another class thread A, that extending thread. So first we need to create a thread, and here I am overriding run method of thread class. And inside this I am using synchronized block, and this synchronized block lock the object of this class. So here I am passing this as a reference variable. When object is locked, here I am printing child thread start, and here I am using for loop that will start, that is start from 0 and up to 100. And here I have declared one variable total is equal to 0, and here I am adding each value into total, and here I am printing system.out.println child thread giving notification. And when I am calling this dot notify method, I can use notify method only inside synchronized area, and this is inside the synchronized area. And now I will test the code. Here I have created one main class, and inside this class I have declared main method, and here I am creating the object of thread class. And if I want to call this run method, I need to start this thread, and when I will call a dot start method, then this method automatically call run method of a thread class, and this part of the code will be execute. And after calling a dot start method, here I have declared synchronized block inside our main method, and here I am looking the this object. After lock the object, here I am printing the main thread is calling, and when thread will call, this will go to waiting state by calling a dot wait method. And main thread got the notification, and here I will print the total number of count. Now I will run this application. Here you can see the output. First main thread calling, after that child thread start, and child thread giving the notification, then main thread got the notification, and here we can see the result 5050. Okay, now we will see another example, that is producer consumer problem. What is producer? Producer will produce the items to the queue, and consumer will consume the items from the queue. First producer will produce, and after that consumer can consume. So consumer will be in the waiting state. If the queue is empty, then consumer has to call wait method on the queue object, then it will enter into the waiting state. And after producing the item, the producer thread will call the notify method. So it is a responsibility of producer method to call the notify method on the queue to give the notification, so that consumer thread will get the notification and consume items. And what is the difference in notify versus notify all method? We can use notify method to give notification for only one thread. If multiple threads are waiting, then only one thread will get the chance, and remaining threads has to wait for further notification. But which thread will be notified, we cannot expect exactly. It depends upon JVM. We can use notify all method to give the notification for all waiting threads. All waiting threads will be notified and will be executed one by one, because they are required lock. And there is one special note on which object we are calling wait, notify and notify all methods. That corresponding object lock we have to get, but not other object locks. Okay, thanks.